How's joint resolution being repealed?
Doesn't really matter. This is why I quote public law 7310. Right. This is the thing, and this is how they get some people. You say, well, House joint resolution could change, but the law never changed. Well, what about public law 7310? 48 statute 48. Yeah, that doesn't change. It's still on the books, you see? So don't worry about that. Go ahead.
Wouldn't Tobago say in 1933, creating a legal vacuum, the void of which was filled by the fiction construct of fraud that led to the judicial system becoming the most corrupt legal system in the world without peer? An identified recent candidate for nomination to the Supreme Court of the United States, Edith Jones, appellate judge, publicly stated the American legal system is corrupt almost beyond all recognition. Fact number 15.
So you got a judge saying that.
All so-called crimes are in fact strictly a commercial matter.
This is important. Even if you can murder, commerce is attached to it. 27 CFR 72.11. Even if it's murder, commerce is in law. Why? Because they bond the criminal. Like, you know why lawyers don't let most people go? Like where 90, if you get a lawyer, most people to get a lawyer end up disappointed. Unless you're really wealthy like OJ. Then they'll break his ass and they'll get him later. You see what I'm saying? If you have a lot of fiat, they'll let you walk for a while. But if you don't, keep in mind, like for everyone that gets like convicted, they're actually making $10,000 a day off of you. $10,000 a day. So you think the lawyer wants your little $5,000 that you're gonna give him for the entire case and gonna let you walk? Guess what? You're just giving him 5 G's, or if you're hustling, you're a drug dealer, you're giving him 15 G's just to ask him some questions, and you're going to get locked up anyways. You're going to get locked up anyways. So you better keep that money for, you know what I mean, for your damn commissary, because you're going to get locked up anyways. You can best believe that. So anytime you hire in a lawyer, also, it means that you're an infant. It means that you're incompetent to speak for yourself. So what people try and do, they'll try and tell the lawyer to submit certain paperwork, and he won't do it, and they're wondering why. And it's like, damn, this guy's acting like he's not even representing me. You know what I mean? It's because he's an officer of the court. So his first entrance is to the court. So now you're trying to go and submit something, and the court said, we can't hear that. Why? Because you have an attorney. So they can't hear anything that you're saying. Go ahead.
CFR, Code of Federal Regulations, Fact Number 16. Ever since June 5th, 1933, because of the bankruptcy of the United States, and when House Joint...
So here you go right here, Brother Reese. Right there.
When House Joint Resolution 192 was unanimously passed, becoming public policy per Public Law 7310...
That's the one you want to remember, the law.
All products of the industrial economic system are of legal, lawful necessity, prepaid.
Now, they state this. If you read the House Joint Resolution, it states it right in here. But you have people that come and argue and say, nah, that's a fraud. And I'm telling you something, those are the kind of people that hurt the rest of us. Because you got people, when you try and teach the truth, you got people that they'll try it, it doesn't work for them. Because they don't really have a clear comprehension of it. Then they'll say, ah, that stuff doesn't work, it's a fraud. You know what I mean? It's because they have not learned it. You know? Like, I can't go, like, he's a carpenter, right? I don't really know anything about carpenter. You trying to get me to put something together? It's not gonna, nah, I want my money back. My floor is not right. You know, there's a tilt on my floor. You see what I'm saying? It's because you have to learn it properly for it to work. This is just like anything else. Like, when you're studying the law, you have to really learn it and learn what words mean, which means you have to unlearn everything that you've learned. Because we've been taught to speak in common parlance, right? We've been taught that a person meant like this brother over here. That's another person. That's you and I talking. But when you're talking in legal lease, person means corporation. You see what I'm saying? Total different meaning. So this is why it's not working for them. Go ahead.
All products, they're prepaid. For example, everything must be paid for by the government to preclude the charges of high treason against Congress, Secretary of Treasury, Board of Governors of Federal Reserve Bank, and the Comptroller of the Currency. This is a historical, irrefutable fact that has been kept secret from you for over 93 years. Time to wake up, maybe? What can we conclude from these facts? Now, these assertions being stated as facts, the following conclusions can be readily arrived at. Number one, pursuing any remedy within the so-called courts is the proverbial barking up the wrong tree, since the so-called courts have an immense financial incentive, as much as $10,000 a day.
That's what I was telling you. For everyone that's convicted, they're benefiting $10,000 a day. Why are they going to let you go? Well, we need him convicted. Why do you think so many so-called blacks and Hispanics are in prison? It's all part of the plan, man. They have to pick someone, we're going to pick them. It's a capitalist society, right? So you turn one against the other, you know, they create something called, when did racism start? You know, people always, it wasn't really like that, you know? It started around the time of Mussolini. You know, that's when they really started to push race. So now you got people hating each other because the higher echelons created that. So now it's a natural paradigm. Go ahead.
$10,000 per day per inmate to convict any and everyone, innocent or guilty, is totally irrelevant. The pretend courts only rake in the big bucks upon securing convictions at all costs.
And this is the other thing. When you go into court, even if you're right, they don't care about that. It's not about, because what's the pleas that you can enter in court right now? Is there a plea of innocent? No, there isn't. Well, what's the three ways that you can plead?
Guilty, you.
Yeah, so they take it away, the innocent plea. So you're already presumed to be guilty. You gotta prove that you're innocent. And you can't prove anything. You see what I'm saying? This is where they get you, okay?
Or as a compromise, obtain lucrative bribes from its victims. Number two, there exists virtually no men, women of integrity left anywhere in the so-called judicial system because potential whistleblowers are not tolerated. The exceptions are far and few between, and those remaining few are virtually powerless to help you. Number three, much as a Chicago mobster Al Capone was virtually untouchable against the direct activities he engaged in, he was vulnerable indirectly through issues of taxation. Number four, the courts consisting of the clerk of the court, prosecutor, deputy prosecutor, pretend judge, and the defense attorney are all profoundly vulnerable to the issues of tax delinquency against their person for the bonds, bills, or true bills being generated off the credit of its accused victims as products of statutes. A product of statute is nothing different than, let's say, a product of an industrial factory that builds automobiles. All these products are indeed prepaid, yet the people in their profound ignorance are expected to somehow pay for these things, even though after the U.S. bankruptcy, the people could no longer pay their debts at law, since it was now legally impossible. No precious metals backed the currency anymore after the confiscation of the gold by executive order. We forget who the real sovereigns are. It is precisely this inability of the people to pay at law their debts that empowers them under Public Law 7310.
Let me ask you this, right? So just think, you know, just think it for yourself. So if FDR took away the gold in 1933 and they finished taking the silver away in 1978, how do you pay your debts? How do you pay public debts? Because, you know, a Federal Reserve note, as I explained, is not money, because the definition of money says it does not embrace notes, right? It says it right. What you got there, Brother Long?
A real silver.
So you got a real silver dollar. So that had real money in it. That had real silver in it.
No, it doesn't say no.
Right? Yeah, it doesn't say no or anything. Yo, let's pass this around. That's how money really was, besides gold and silver coins, bunions. So, what we have now, Federal Reserve note, man.
Funny money, monopoly money.
So is that why they killed JFK?
Yeah, that is why they assassinated
him. Maybe.
And Lincoln also.
And Lincoln also.
And Abraham Lincoln. Because Abraham Lincoln bought out the greenbacks, right?
That's correct.
That was real money, right? And so the reason that they really assassinated John Fitzgerald Kennedy is because he was going to bring real money back in the population. What did they do? They got rid of it. They assassinated him. Right? Because on Federal Reserve notes, this is owned by a private company, the Federal Reserve Bank. So-called Jews. I'll say so-called Jews because they're not real Jews. They own the Federal Reserve Bank. And so the United States government have to pay them interest on all of this that they print. And they print it out of thin air. But it doesn't have no value attached. And so, what does the government do to you? Because they gotta pay interest on this? They tax you. They tax you. They tax you. They tell you you gotta pay income taxes. But I thought it was illegal for a man to pay taxes to provide himself a living. Think about that. You gotta pay taxes just to eat to live? Doesn't make sense. Go ahead.
Public law 7310 to be able to exercise their exemption, exempt from paying, to achieve set off mutual cancellation of debt for any and all debts that the sovereign accepts. We are all sovereigns pursuant to the United Declaration of Independence of July 4, 1776, making us subject to no other man, only God, the absolute sovereign. All men are created equal. Now, do you remember?
Does anyone know where that is in the scriptures? That man has authority and dominion over all?
Genesis.
Yeah, we're in Genesis. We're Hebrews. We like to have specific verses. Colin, with the brother right there, with the name of the Most High on his neck.
I can't even think of it right.
You know, good brother?
So, yeah.
Someone pull up the book of Genesis 1 and 8 on your phone.
Thank you. 1 and 8.
Book of Genesis, chapter 1, verse 8. Let's see what that says, man. Bahashama Mashiach Yahushah. Supposed to know this, man. I mean, you're supposed to know this because, I mean, if you go before them, it says right here, because remember, they get you to take an oath. Sometimes they don't even use the Bible anymore, but your oath is based on the Bible. You see? Because this is a Judeo-Christian society, supposedly. So it's supposed to be based on the Bible. That's the whole thing with the judge wearing a black robe. It's a priestly garment. That's what he's emulating. So they're practicing Roman civics laws. But it's all, you know, it used to be that you would actually go before the priest. They replaced that with the courts. You would actually go before a council, a priesthood, and they would decide what's right and wrong. Now they replaced it with this court system. Someone pulled that book of Genesis chapter 1, verse 8 on a smartphone, dumb phone, average smartphone.
I think it's 28.
Yeah, read what you got.
It says, I got the secret. It said, Elohim blessed them. Elohim said unto them, be fruitful, multiply, and replenish the earth.
Yeah.
And have dominion over the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over every living thing that moves.
So every living thing. So man was given dominion over everything. Over everything. So if man has dominion over everything, he created the court systems, he has dominion over that. And it tells you that in the Declaration of Independence. It specifically tells you that. That the power of the government comes from the governed, comes from the consent, meaning the agreement of the governed. And it goes on to tell you in pertinent parts that if the government becomes unruly, it is the duty of the people to abolish and to replace the government. But the government's become a 3,000-pound gorilla, and the people are afraid of the damn government. I mean, real talk. Go ahead.
We being the sovereign are the only source of commercial energy. All funds that exist within the economy ultimately belong to a sovereign entity.
So this is the, since there's no real money, right? Because guess what? They took the gold. And who have they been paying with our gold? Who have they been paying with the gold? Because the U.S. was actually bankrupt. Who was they bankrupt to? Yeah. So I mean, that's who's there. So this is why attorneys carry titles of nobility, like esquire. You're not supposed to be able to hold public office with a title of nobility, like an esquire. Go ahead.
Sovereign inhabitant of the land. No government has the capacity to generate any positive commercial energy.
So guess what this comes from? This comes from your work. So whenever you sign, notice anything, the only thing they want you to do is sign for a mortgage, for a car loan, for everything. Once they got your signature and your social security number, that's all they need. They got you. What do you think they're doing? They're tapping into your treasury direct account. Even when you work in the system, you think you're earning money. No, you're not. They're using your energy, and guess what they're doing? Guess where that money's coming from? It's coming out of your treasury direct account. Why do you think they're asking for your social security number? They're asking for your social security number because they're going right into your treasury direct account and they got your signature. Now they're accessing it. They're going right in there and they're paying you with your own money. How do you like that? How do you like that? That's what they're doing, man. Go ahead, read.
Only to generate destruction, death, death as pure physical existence.
Because, I mean, think about it. What happens? Why do they cause such a catastrophe? Because the Social Security on the card, it tells you not to share this number, right? So why does Jobs become so irate when he said, I'm going to give a social? Well, why did they get so upset? Because that means they would actually have to pay you. And they don't have anything to pay you, so they're going into your account.
Good.
But what happens when you file the 1099 OID? That closes the bookings. They're not able to go into your account anymore. See, right now, there's an attorney that's actually appointed to actually go into your account. But if you close the bookings, when you file the 1099 OID, that account is closed. So they don't have access to it anymore. This is how people are able to get out of jail and prison, right? Because they're bonded. All these people are bonded. There's something known as a CUSIP number, right? When a person is convicted, right? When you go to like court and you're convicted, this guy is assigned a CUSIP number. And so whoever the prosecutor was or whoever, whatever court he got locked up in, that's the court that you're supposed to go back to and try and get that person out. You gotta find out who's holding that bond and that CUSIP number. And every time you go to an arraignment, there's something known as an appearance bond, right? If you satisfy the appearance bond, they'll let you go. You know what the black rule let people go when they go to an arraignment? Is because they signed that appearance bond. So when you sign that appearance bond, you know, you're essentially creating a promissory note, so they're getting paid. They're getting paid. But if you close all of these avenues out, that means in order for you to stay, because people that's in jail, they're gonna pay for them to stay there, right? Yeah. They're not there for free. So if you close this out with a 1099 OID, they can't access the account anymore. So either one of the people that put you there is gonna have to start paying this, or they're gonna have to go in your stead. So they release people like that. This is why you got people in prison that's trying to do this stuff now. Go ahead.
Existence upon the positive productive energy of the sovereigns. These concepts are not some pie in the sky mental exercise.
Well, let me say this. Let me make this very clear. Because I have a lot of criminals, like real criminals, that try and contact me all of the time, right? I'm not into helping people that break the law. I believe that someone goes out and robs someone or shoots someone, I don't think they should sit up in jail. I think they should be killed. I think they should get the electric chair, at least. Those are the laws of the scriptures. I don't think if you go out and rob an elderly lady, that she should be able to walk. This is why you need the police for Negroes like that. And other people that do that, this is make the police necessary. You see what I'm saying? People that go out and sell drugs, right? Like cocaine and things like that. That's a slow form of death, right? You're killing people. Because those drugs that you sold to that woman, now look at her children. You see what I'm saying? The guy said, well, I gotta eat, right? But look what you're doing to the society and the community. So they deserve to be locked up. You understand? I don't help people like that. But people that's like innocently, like just taking control of, I don't agree with that. And that's what I try and like fight against. Go ahead.
But are the hard reality that the dark forces fully recognize and go to such lengths to keep hidden from us, with great ingenuity and cunning, the dark forces have attempted to totally neutralize these impediments to achieving total enslavement of sovereigns by making them think they are subject to their servants, the greatest of all con jobs in the history of man. Is there anything we can do?
So what can we do about this, good brother? Your brother's in the back from Detroit, right?
Yes.
7 mile, 8 mile, 9 mile, what?
Missouri River.
All right. Yeah, that's a rough place, man. It's out there a couple times. So, I mean, what do you think we can do about it, brother?
We can make some changes. So, a whole lot of jobs have for ourselves. That's all that's going to happen.
Right. Okay.
So, how do we turn the table on the greed, total corruption, and infinite evil in control of this wicked system to assert our sovereignty, to restore the de jure republic where everyone is a sovereign with no subjects, and put a stop to the domestic terrorism, rape, robbery, and pillaging being committed against the sovereigns? Should we just wait for the promised divine destruction of the entire global system as guaranteed to eventually happen in the scriptures?
This is what a lot of Israelites want to do. They just say, well, you're only waiting on Mashiach. To me, that's the same concept of Christianity. I mean, they'll just say, well, we just wait, we can do it. The Lord's going to, come on, man, you can't totally have that concept. But what are you going to do now? So, I mean, and they're telling me, oh, no, you're not supposed to be wealthy in this cell. But then I tell them, well, hold on. King Solomon was very well off. You know, King David was very well off. So I mean, what do you mean you can't keep the laws and you know, be wealthy? No, there's something going on wrong here, man. Why would you want to worship a power that wants you to be poor, broke, hungry? Come on, man. Think a little bit. Go ahead.
That admittedly has a 1,000% batting average so far, or if we have the knowledge to do so, to put into actions that can free the unjustly incarcerated and help set up circumstances that can severely curtail, if not cause to implode upon itself by its own accord.
Yeah, you know how many people are in prison that should be there? Anyone see that? What was that young guy that got for carrying a backpack? Yeah, he was in New York, had a backpack, he got arrested. Got thrown on Rikers Island for about 3.5 years for something he didn't even do. They put the guy through so much turmoil. When he got out, he ended up committing suicide. And messed him up so bad, man. Messed him up so bad. There's a lot of people that go through that. Okay?
The criminal enterprise impersonating a judicial system. Since the criminal enterprise impersonating the judicial system is protected, supported, and mutually profiting from the plunder they generate, all the way to the Supreme Courts of both state and federal venues, they actually are in the same one federal system since the state is mere federal instrumentality, then we must seek remedy outside of the state and federal so-called government, the de facto, that has a superior position. The United States and its federal instrumentality, such as the state of wherever, all went bankrupt in 1933 and went into receivership. The creditor in the bankruptcy is the International Monetary Fund, or the IMF.
So this is who controls the IRS. The IRS essentially is a bookkeeping agency for the IRS. I mean for the IMF, which is so-called Jews. Okay?
World Bank, which uses their collection enforcement branch called the Internal Revenue Service to service payments into the phony bankruptcy that is being used as subterfuge to extort money from the people through the income tax scam. The federal tax forms provide a tool for remedy. A federal tax form suggested for use for extortion of funds from individuals is the 1040 form.
Well, let's stop right here. Let's take like a 10-minute break. 10-minute break. Let's circulate. Let's stop right here. Well, we'll get back to this.